Welcome to experiment 7, pulse code modulation and demodulation. These are two kits for the modulation and demodulation purpose. Let us look one by one. We see firstly this kit, modulation kit. Here there is a 16 megahertz crystal oscillator. This is 16 megahertz crystal oscillator, and it is producing two signals. One is 320 kilohertz, and there are two channels. At first channel, first the 2 kilohertz sinusoidal signal, and in this second channel there is a 4 kilohertz sinusoidal signal. After this signal, we connect this signal to this point, so we can see the signal here, this point on the CRO and this point on the CRO. Both signals are same, and these two signals are connected. After this, the one preamplifier is here, that is giving the gain of 1, means the same signal is here. And here the sampling signal is coming, two sampling signals, sampling signal 1 and sampling signal 2. Sampling signal 1 for the channel 1 and sampling signal 2 for the channel 2. Or these two channels, these two sampling signals are time division multiplexed signal, and here these two are demultiplexed. This means the one is at one particular time, and another signal is at the right side of the that signal. Means these two are not overlapping time frame. These two signals are different time slots. Means these two are able to two signals at the channel 1 and the channel 2 separately, and these two signals can sample these two channel signal at the same time. These signals here, and at this point this signal and this signal, these two signals are same. After the sampling, here we get the sampled signal, or after the sample and hold, we get the output of sample and hold. Means that signal is sampled. Sampled will hold at a particular time. That this sample and hold circuit will give here the sample and hold signal. And after the sampling, the signal is to quantized and encoded. So here analog to digital converter is converted to sampled signal into encoded signal. Here the error check codes are available. If we want to remove the error at the channel, error in the channel, then we can use here the parity bits, even parity, odd parity, a Hamming code. Here we see only in off position. These two are in off position. Means here we are not assuming the channel error. We are assuming channel is noiseless. Means that encoded signal is here. That encoded signal is parallel to serial connected. Means here one sampled signal is connected to in 7 bits, and these 7 bits are transmitted one by one bit. And after transmitting the one sample, another sample 7 bit transmitted. Means here there is a need of parallel to serial converter. This parallel to serial converter converts all bit, parallel data bits, into the serial data bits, and this serial data bit is transmitted from this point, and this is received signal here, and this received signal, we can see that transmitted signal here is here. We can see the same signal is received here. We can see after some time, So here the received signal, and here this is the error detection and correction. Here these two are off because we are not assuming the error in the channel. So after this, here the transmitted code is received in at this position, and these codes are these digital data is firstly converted into the labels. Means these signals are quantized, is converted to quantization label, and these quantization labels are holded by the sample and hold circuit. And after this low pass filter is used for reconstruction purpose, and we get the output here that should be same as the transmitted signal that was transmitted from here. When we transmit this signal 2 kHz sinusoidal signal, then we get the 2 kHz sinusoidal wave. When we transmit the 4 kHz sinusoidal signal, we get here 4 kHz sinusoidal we will get after some time. And here this is the for synchronization purpose. We want to synchronize these two. So this is the needed. There is a need of synchronization. So it is connected to from here to there. And this is the for the clock purpose. Here the transmitted clock and the receiver clock. Transmitted clock and receiver clock should be same. And that time we will on both the kits at the same time. Otherwise clock will be different, and the clock will be different, then received signal and transmitted signal, transmitted data will be differing. This is connected for transmitted output and received output. Here the transmitted data and this is the received data, both should be same ground level. Means here we are connected, this is the ground point, this ground point, and this ground point of these two kits are connected. And if we want to we do not use the clock synchronization, if we do not use this for the clock, transmitted clock and received clock, then we can use this circuit. This is the recovery of the carrier signals. This is the used for recovery of the carrier signal. This is the just like a PLL circuit. PLL circuit is used for the demodulation of the FM frequency modulation, and this is also used for the recovery of the carrier signal. So this here from this we give the data here, and we take the output from here to this clock, and that time there is no need of the same clock at the same clock in the transmitter kit and the receiver kit. We use the in receiver side we use the PLL, that is the carrier recovery circuit, or this carrier recovery circuit will generate the same clock, that is the same clock as a transmitted clock. So alternatively we can use this, and firstly we use this clock should be same, and after this we will on both the kits and we get the signals at a particular points. Here we want to see the message signal. Here the message signal is in the channel 1. Channel 1 is yellow color signal. This is the message signal. This message signal, here if we change the amplitude of the signal, then the amplitude of the signal is changing. Means here we are changing the amplitude. The signal amplitude is changing, and the frequency is the frequency of this signal is 2 kHz, and here it is showing 2 kHz. And transmitted signal is 2 kHz signal, and here received signal is also received signal, this point this is on channel 2, this received signal is same as the transmitted signal with some delay. With some delay, and we can change it by this channel. If we transmit this channel we can see the output, we can see the input from the channel 1, and the frequency of this signal is 4 kHz, that is written here, 4 kHz sinusoidal signal, and here it is showing the 4 kHz frequency of the channel 2, and we can calculate the channel 1 frequency by using the 100 microsecond, and 100 microsecond is the division, and we can shift this by this, and we can calculate 2.5 nearly. 2.5 means 100 microsecond, 250, and 250 then 1 divided by 250 microsecond will give you 4 kilohertz. Means here we can calculate the frequency of the channel 1 is 4 kilohertz, and received signal has the frequency of 4 kilohertz, that is the same as this. So here when we transmit the 4 kHz sinusoidal signal, we receive the 4 kHz sinusoidal signal. If we transmit the 2 kHz sinusoidal signal, we receive the 2 kHz sinusoidal signal. If we can change the amplitude level of this and the amplitude level of this. These two channels, the channel 1 and channel 2, has the same amplitude per division, same voltage per division, that is 20 volt per division, and 20 volt per division, and channel 2 frequency is 2 kHz, and here 250 microsecond, and we can see the time period of this. So the time period is 1 block, 2 block, nearly 2 block, and here 250 multiplied by 2 means 500 microsecond, and 1 divided by 500 microsecond will give the 2 kilohertz. So these two signals have the same frequency, that is 2 kilohertz. So we can see here the each step output. Here these are the sampled signal. We can see the sampled signal here. Here this is the pulse train that is used for the sampling purpose, and this is the sampled signal. So we can see here by increasing the amplitude, here we are able to see the output. Here the sampled signal is this. Show the frequency of the sampled signal here, 250, and the time period of this signal by shifting these two signals. Here the 1, 2, nearly 2 blocks, and 250 multiplied by 2 blocks. 250 multiplied by 2 blocks, 500, and it will give the frequency of 20 kilohertz. 20 kilohertz we will see the frequency of the sampled signal frequency. We can see the samples per division. Samples in a clock in a single period. Here there is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, total there are 20 samples per second. Means the sampling frequency is 20 samples per second. So it is 20 samples per second. and he after this we can see the output here. The here the output is in the form of auto run, and we get the output at this point. That is the digital data. Here we are seeing all LEDs are blinking continuously, but these are not continuously blinking. But here the frequency sampling frequency, here the 320 kilohertz, if this is set to 320 kilohertz, if we set this at the position of 1.9 and this is also at the 1.9, so this 1.9 for the visualization purpose. So we can see here these same signals are transmitted, and this signal and this signal, we can see these signals should be same. So this is 1.9 hertz for the visualization purpose and 320 kilohertz for practical purpose. So we want to perform this experiment, so we set at the 320. So here the output signal is same as the input signal. Here this is the transmitted data. So stop, run and stop. Here we can see this is the transmitted data, and these are the received data. We can see here these two are the same type of data. So if we increase this, these are the same as transmitted. Means here this is the transmitted data and this is the received data. This received data is serial to parallel converter. Here the parallel data is, and these parallel data is converted to digital to analog. Means here this output is at the sampled at the quantized level, and here we can see these are the digital data, and here these are the quantized data. Means we can see here the output, how output is just like quantization level. These are the quantized level of output. Here these quantized level are passing through the sample and hold. This sample and hold is able to hold the sampled values as quantized levels. These quantized levels are connected. So the low pass filter, means reconstruction filter, will get convert to the output signal. This output signal is this, and this output signal we can see here the sampled, this is the same edge. So 1 minute, here the sampled output, and we see the here output is sample and hold. Means here the sampled, not sampled, that is the quantized. The quantized value is hold, and after getting the next value, that will be hold and that will be held continuously. And after these levels are continuously connected, we get the here. This is the output. This low pass filter is continuously connected these points and will converted into the output. Here this is the output at the channel 2, and this channel output is same as the input signal. Here the input signal is this, and the output signal is the input signal and output signal. These two, and with some delay, but these two have the same frequency. Means these two signals this signal, first channel one signal is transmitted signal, means our original message signal, and this is our received message signal. This is the received message signal, and this is the transmitted this is the original message signal, and this is the received signal. So we can see in alternatively, we do not want to use the same clock, we want to use of this data. So we take the connecting cords, and this data we disconnect from here to there, and we want to give this data is given here, and after that this data is for the clock, and we have taken here, and we can run it, and after adjusting the delay and the BCO frequency, we get the by setting these two knobs, by using these two knobs, we get the output voltage, and this is the transmitted signal, and this is the received signal. Here the clock is not taken at the clock of transmitter clock and receiver clock, these two are not connected, means here we have to use the recovery carrier circuit, that is PLL circuit, and we give the data that is received here, give the PLL circuit, means recovery carrier circuit, and we take the clock from here. So this point is connected to this point, and this will generate the same clock, that is transmitted clock here, that is generated here, and we get the output. Thank you.